Okay, so for your exercise on regular expressions, I'm going to challenge you to create a regular expression to match a phone number, specifically in the format of US phone numbers. So open parentheses, three numbers, closed parentheses, a space, three numbers, a dash, and then four numbers. I want you to come up with a pattern and then test your pattern against different strings to see if it accurately identifies phone numbers. I've provided a few hints to help you with creating that regular expression, but I'll see you after the pause. Go ahead and pause right now. Okay, welcome back. Let's see if you have the same thing that I have. Okay, so I can't just put an open parentheses because parentheses are reserved characters within regular expressions, kind of like how you can't just say D for digit. You have to denote it as a special character. And similarly to a D for digit, I have to escape certain characters if I want to display it as is. So if I put a backslash in front of that parentheses, then that basically means I want it to display as is. And then from the previous lesson, we know that backslash D means any numerical digit, and I want three of them. And then I want to close the parentheses, make sure you escape it with that backslash. A space is a normal space. And then again, a backslash D for numerical digits, and I want three of them. And then a dash is fine. It doesn't need to be escaped. And then again, four digits. There you go. That's the regular expression to figure out that specific format. Let's go ahead and test that inside ServiceNow. And run it. Does it match? False. What did I do wrong? Ah, I see what I did wrong. I put these as parentheses instead of curly brackets. Fun fact, parentheses, groups of parentheses means capture group. And so when I left it like that, it was actually looking for the specific group of characters within that parentheses at that moment. So it was looking for another actual number three, which we don't want it to do that. We want it to be digits. So I change it to curly brackets and let's see if it works. There it goes. Now it works. Whoops. But that's a good way to see that you have to go back and check your work.